This is the installation guide for the 2022 Good Mondays digital planners. In this video, I'm going to go over how to install it onto your iPad onto GoodNotes 5, as well as how to load the stickers that come with the planner onto your apps. Just a quick recap of what planners you can choose from. There's the time planner, which has the monthly, weekly, and daily planning pages. Then we have the weekly planner, which has only monthly and weekly layouts. Lastly, we have the daily planner, which only has monthly and daily layouts. All the planners come with the same 10 covers. The different product images are just to show the variations of the covers so you can have a peek at what you get. All planners also come with the everyday sticker pack included. Now on to installation. Once your purchase has gone through, you should receive an email with a download link, which upon clicking will bring you to this page. Sometimes there's a glitch with this page where it loads as a bunch of random symbols, or it doesn't load at all. So if this happens to you, please email me at your earliest convenience and I'll provide you with a direct link to the planner download through email. Once you tap download, you'll notice that it looks like nothing happens, but if you look closely at the top here, you'll see this little wheel just turning to show you that it's downloading the file. And usually with these downloads, they go straight to the downloads folder in your Files app. So once it's done, please navigate to the Files app on your iPad, and in the Downloads folder, you'll see the zip file that you just downloaded from that page. All you have to do now is tap on it to unzip it, and a folder will appear adjacent to it that has all the planner files and stickers inside. So now let's head into the folder. As you can see, there are four main items in here. You'll have your folder containing the stickers, your planner files in Monday Start, the installation guide, and then the planner files in Sunday Start. Now heading into the Monday Start folder, you'll see three different planner files. You will only see this if you purchased a time planner or weekly planner, since there are three different weekly layouts to choose from. There is a box layout, a classic layout, and a vertical hourly layout, and the files are named accordingly. If you want to use Sunday Start, then tap into the Sunday Start folder. Classic is by far the most popular and it's what I like to use, so I'm going to tap on it. Now the file is open in your Files app and you'll be able to see all the pages in it. To export it to your note-taking app, tap the share icon on the top right and you'll be able to export it to your note-taking app of choice. My go-to is always GoodNotes 5, so this is where I'm going to export it to. Before importing the template into GoodNotes, you can quickly rename it to something like My Planner, whatever you like, and once you're done, you can import it as a new document. If you're using a landscape planner, at first glance, you're going to see these gaps on the side and you want your planner to be full screen, so just use your finger and double tap on the screen. This will make your landscape planner fill the screen. Next, you're probably going to want to start playing with hyperlinks, but you'll notice that your pen might be drawing over it. This is because you need to activate read-only mode on the top right corner. Once this mode has been activated, you can freely tap on the hyperlinks within the planner. Please note that the hyperlinks will differ depending on which planner you purchase. For instance, the weekly planner will not have hyperlinks to the daily pages, and the daily planner will not have hyperlinks to the weekly pages. Now that we've got hyperlinks out of the way, how do we choose a planner cover since the file comes with 10? Well, you can open thumbnail view in GoodNotes, select the ones you don't want to use and either delete them or move them to the back of the planner. Now for stickers, which is one of the best parts of using a digital planner. The stickers that come with the planner are provided in a format that works with GoodNotes 5 Elements, which is one of their new features for managing and storing stickers. So head back to your folder with all the planner and sticker files and go into the individual PNGs folder where you'll find 137 individual sticker files. Tap select, then select all, and at the bottom here, tap the share icon and save them to images. The reason why you want to save them to images is because right now, GoodNotes 5 only lets you multi-select from photos when importing elements and not from files, and you don't want to be sitting here for an hour importing 137 stickers individually from your files. So double check that the sticker files have been saved to your photos. Now head back into GoodNotes, tap on the Elements feature, and scroll to the very right to the plus sign. Tap on this plus sign to create a new Elements collection. You can name it whatever you like. Then at the bottom left here, select Import from Photos. At this point, your photo album will pop up and you can use your finger or pencil to just drag across all the stickers until you get all of them. Then tap Add on the top right. Your photos will be added as elements, then you can tap Create. Your stickers are now ready to be used in GoodNotes. All you have to do now is open the Elements window again, scroll through the collection to find the sticker you want to use and tap on it. It'll pop up on the screen, at which point you can resize, rotate, and place a sticker wherever you like. This here is a sample spread that I used in some of my preview photos, and you can see that there are just so many fun ways that you can play with stickers, which is one of the reasons why people enjoy digital planning so much. So now let's move on to using the notepad. The notepad has 12 different sections you can customize, and they are all hyperlinked from the notepad index as well as the index page at the front of the planner. You'll notice that the sections are all empty upon installation, but this is because you can build your own sections using the four notepaper templates provided. There are two ways to do this. First is to head to the template you want to use, and on the top right, tap the three dots and then tap copy page. Then in thumbnail view, go to the section you want to build, tap the arrow at the bottom of the thumbnail, tap add page after, and then paste page. You'll see that the template will appear after that section, so now you have your first page within it. Another way to do this is to stay in thumbnail view, pick the template you want to use, and then duplicate. You can then tap and hold on the duplicated page and move it to the section you want to use. You can keep duplicating and moving the pages around as you need. I find this method to be a lot faster than the first one. And that is pretty much it for the notepad. It's super simple and customizable to your needs. You just build the sections as you need them using the notepaper templates provided. So I hope you found this video guide helpful. If you still have any questions or need further assistance, please don't hesitate to reach out to me at hello@goodmondays.ca. Thanks for watching.